Hello, I'm Simon Crafer. We're in Austin, Texas at the Circuit of Americas. And this week's Tech Talk subject is onboard cameras in MotoGP. When I was first suggested this, I thought, how, you know, interesting can it be? But there's a lot more technology and a lot more to it than I imagined. You know, I've spent the last couple of days digging. So here we go. So there is six onboard cameras in Moto 3, but they're smaller because the bikes are smaller, less powerful, and they only carry one camera, so six machines out there. Then Moto 2, there's six machines, but they carry the same system that you're about to see as MotoGP, which is up to four cameras any one time. And then you move to MotoGP, there's 24 systems available for MotoGP, 24 riders, but each rider has two machines, so half of the field are covered by onboard cameras. And there's a bit of predicting that goes on here, so they use journalists to help choose who should have the onboard cameras on. And I know this feeling of sitting in your garage as a rider and then the onboard camera guys turn up, you know, start putting cameras all over your bike and you're like, what's going on here? And you kind of feel a bit special because these guys think you're in the fight on Sunday, you know, you're worth covering. And but the same in reverse, when they come to take off those onboard cameras, you think, oh, they don't think I'm in the fight on Sunday, you know. So that still goes on every weekend. So next thing to tell you about is a book that the onboard team make. It's a book that explains to the manufacturer with files to explain weights, what each piece does and what they need to be able to mount the system on the bike. Mounting points, areas, holes in the fairing to, for the cameras to look through and lots more, but you know, all the wiring, where it goes. And obviously these bikes get designed years before. So for example, right now, they're giving files to the manufacturers for the future, for their future machines, you know. Then the trust side is really important because you're talking about sensitive equipment, meaning factory machines that I feel envious. I'm out in the pit lane looking in and the onboard guys are working on factory bikes, taking the seat unit off, changing a battery, putting a new camera on a seat unit. After crashes, they have to get in there and replace cameras once the bikes are built back up. And there's a real trust that needs to never be broken, and they've managed to do that for years. So basically these onboard guys never speak about what they see. And so let's talk about the equipment itself. So let's start with the front camera on the machine. This is the one that, you know, the front of the bike where a headlight would be, the number is there, there's a hole, and this is looking through the hole in the front of the bike, and that's the view you will see on the website, you know, when you're watching MotoGP.com. And every lens on this bike is also a gyro. And so that's why it's quite big here. It's a really small lens, gyro, but the electronics to run it, you know, so when the bike leans over, it always keeps a level. The electronics to run it are in here as well. So let's go back. All of these lenses, the whole system is HD. So this is the one. It's called the helmet cam, but it basically, where the taco is and the, you know, the dash, it looks back at the rider's face, you know? You'll remember that shot. And all that's a small lens in there, and all the electronics can tuck away under the dash, you know, out of the way. Then we move back here to, next one we'll start with is here, the rear-facing cam. So the seat unit's up here. This is inside the seat unit. And the rear facing cam's normally under the seat unit, above the rear wheel, looking back at the rider behind. You'll remember that shot. Same thing, gyro, cam, HD, all the electronics inside there. Then if we jump over the other side here, we've got the butt cam, which is looking at the rider's butt. And what I was gonna say is the same deal, gyro inside. You know, let's move on to the others before I tell you about the development into these. There's two others here. They're well proud of this one because it sits in the same place, but it can be controlled by, you know, by the onboard guys live to follow and overtake, you know, looking anywhere. It's pretty trick. And this one here is the one, the last time I saw this one was on in Argentina on Morbidelli's bike, and it has four cameras, 1, 2, 3, 4, and the signal goes to Barcelona, believe it or not, and gets stitched together, so it's a 360 view, and you can go on the website and live see with your phone, move around like this, and it will show you anywhere you want to look, you know. So the development side, I should say, while I've got this in my hands, is quite amazing, because these guys are leaders of onboard cameras, so they can't just buy the equipment. All of it is developed in-house, and I wish I could have shot it in their workshop, because it's beautiful, but some sensitive material in there. For example, they work with the leading camera manufacturers in the world. I can't tell you the names, but the big boys. So, and they are interested in supplying equipment because it's development for them as well. And so they're helping with lenses or software, but all of the exterior stuff here and a lot of the electronics inside is built in-house. So what I got to witness was the guys in the workshop modifying some things here and saying, we need this to clip on because it's a quick release in a different way, or change the shape of a body. What they do is request that to one of their guys. He draws it up on the CAD and then sends it to Barcelona near the base. They make a one-off, they get to test it. If it works, they order it for all the bikes, and they're constantly developing like this. The other thing is all the wiring. They're doing more and more possibilities, which I'm going to show you in a moment. And so extra wires, and then the wires get messy. They can't have that on the bike, so they do another loom that it all comes back down to one wire again, you know. So anyway, let's go on to the next thing I want to show you is the battery. And the thing is, the more they do, for example, this multi-box here on top, it by Bluetooth gets signals like all of the telemetry, you know, for example, gear position, RPM, lean angle, what is that, front brake pressure. They can do much, much more than they're currently doing, but it comes down to how sensitive, you know, the manufacturers are, what they want. Like, for example, you could have tire temperature, anything that the bike gathers, it can send to give to us, but some stuff the manufacturers don't want to share with us. So the other thing is, so more and more demand as the technology moves up on the battery. And the battery and everything else is limited. They've already agreed the weight, the size, so they can't make it bigger. So they've got to make it more efficient. And to keep, they're saying that's a real challenge, to keep everything the same size, but keep improving, you know, it's a real challenge. Also battery life. Now they do by remote through here from their base in the paddock, they can turn the battery off after every session, turn it back on for every session, because the last thing they want to do is have to go and disturb, you know, only once a day they go in, plug a new battery in, and they're disturbing the team and the mechanics. Then the rest of the day they can turn it on and off, and at the end they can go and plug in a brand new battery again, or the next morning. Let's move on to, also the multi-box by Bluetooth takes the rider information. They're doing heart rate, etc. right now, but they could do much more, but it comes down to what the broadcasters want also and want to pay for. Also, it's all HD quality at the moment, but the guys are telling me they can go up no problem right now to 4K, but it comes down to what the broadcasters want to pay for, if they want the quality to raise or not. So far not, because there's no point spending money here if nobody's going to pay for it, you know, nobody wants it. Sorry, I've got to look at my list to get it. Heart rate, batteries, remote, we've already done that. Signal, yeah. The signal sent out through this here, goes on the back of the bike. As the bike goes around the lap, there's not one tower, there's up to 8 towers. So it depends on the size of the circuit. The most they use is 8 at a big track like Circuit Americas. And it's so, it never drops out. It jumps from one terminal to the other, or one tower to the other as the lap goes around. And then we can talk to about in the future, and you would have already seen it, they have shoulder cam, which is a beautiful shot. But right now, I mean, they've tested it, and right now I'm hoping in the future we're going to see it on all the riders out there. But right now they're developing it because it has to be an even smaller lens, still gyro, you know, so it stays level all the time. But they've got to work with the leather manufacturers, all of them, and give them samples and information of where the wire has to run, where the antenna is, where the battery is, etc., all in the hump, but without restricting the riders, the drinking pack and things like that. So fingers crossed, we're going to get shoulder cam on all the riders in the future. So there is, out on track during the race, during qualifying practice, 90 cameras feeding back. And actually there's a couple on the safety car, and there's a guy on the gravel running, you know, the marshal rescuing people, so probably 95.5, something like that. All of these cameras feed back to the IPF, where the guys are looking at all the TV screens, one each shot, and there is a director just for onboard camera shots. And he has got his job is to look at these 90 with a couple other guys and choose the best 12 shots, meaning it's a fight for the championship, or it's an incident that's happened, or a crash, or a fight in the race. These 12 best, you know, best shots get sent to the race direction of TV, you know, so he's the main man, and he chooses the shot that, you know, you're talking 150, 160 cameras around the track, plus the all gets narrowed down, plus all the onboards, all gets narrowed down to one shot that's fed through to your TV. So now you know what goes into it when you see an onboard shot. Thanks for listening. We'll see you in Portugal for the next Tech Talk.